So it's tw not 12 o'clock. It is 12:02 at the moment, and it is October 2nd. And technically, it's Chan's birthday right now. Yay! Yay! So last year for his birthday, I made a video explaining kind of how I came about stan Chan, and that was very emotional. I'm not gonna hopefully be that emotional this time. We shall see. Honestly, this is not a planned, not unplanned. This is not a scripted video. Last year I scripted the video, but now it is not, because it is not. It's not because it's not. Makes perfect sense. I don't even know where to start, which is why I should have scripted the video, but it's fine. I guess I'll just talk about the year, like, or since his birthday last year. A lot of things have. I dropped my pen. A lot of things have changed since then. I'm a college student now. Not same. Well, you guys heard it. I'm a college freshman right now. Since last year. Oh, geez. Oh, wow. Okay, wow. Actually, a lot of things have changed since then. Since his birthday last year. A lot of things have happened to me that have made me into a different person, I would say. But I've learned a lot through those experiences. But I think what has stood out to me as I prepared posts for on Instagram for his birthday and stuff like that, and as I just kind of reflected on what on not what it means, but like on what it means to me to look up to someone like Chan, I think the phrase that's been on my mind, I guess, is that without this may seem a little bit like codependent or dependent, but without hard for me to say it out loud, because without, I don't like to say this out loud, without Chris, I don't think, I would be the same person. I said I wasn't gonna get emotional. I don't think I would be the same person as I am today. I think I would be a very different person without the influence he's had on my life, because I feel like in an odd way stanning him has made me a better person, or has made me want to become a better person, and because of this desire in me to want to become to better myself, I have changed the ways that I deal with certain situations. This time last year there was a certain issue going on, and I was just very, very lost and confused. And, jeez. I don't know if I said this in the last. No, I couldn't have said this in the last video because it was happening during the last video. I was debating on. I was debating on self-harm. Hopefully YouTube won't take this down. Please don't take this down, YouTube. I was debating on self-harm, just because I felt as if I couldn't control the situation that was happening to me, and I felt as if I couldn't control it, then I should control the things that I could, and that included the thoughts of hurting myself, and then. And then Bang Chan happened. I was stanning him before that point, and I'm so grateful that I was, because dang, he's just like a friend. But even though he's not my friend, he's a friend, and that's crazy, because you can't say that about too many people. He saved my life many, many times. I don't know how that's possible. What? I'm crying. I didn't even know how I was crying until I felt it. Okay, I was saying, oh yeah, I've been thinking about this too. I'm taking psychology in college, and we were talking about just like the kind of like signals your brain sends when it does, when the signals your brain, the signals that get sent to your brain when you experience certain things, or the signals that are sent from your brain to the rest of your body when you have to do certain things, and it's like, what kind of signals or chemicals are released when you like, it's so weird to me because I've never met Bang Chan, I've never seen him in person, I've never talked to him. It's like, but yet how do I feel this sort of gratefulness towards someone I've never met? It's just this insane thought, and I keep circulating it in my brain, like, what kind of chemicals in your brain like allow for that kind of emotion? Like, I just am really quite grateful for him. Yeah, without him there is no me, which sounds very like Aaron, you're over dramatic, wow, but at the same time it's like, no, it's not as serious as I'm making it out to be, but it's just the best way that I can describe my gratitude. English major time. So the hashtag for this year, I sound so dead inside. The hashtag for his birthday this year is hashtag our haven Bang Chan. And the dictionary definition of haven is a place of safety or refuge. And just in the world right now, we're quite possibly in the least safe time that we've ever, not ever been, but like that we've been in a while. And so to have some semblance of safety, whether it's in a place or a person, is very important for all of us. And so I just, again, I'm grateful that we all have something to make us feel safe. Someone to make us feel safe, like Bang Chan. I don't know what to say. I guess to Chan, as if he'll ever see this. Actually, he might, which is terrifying. I look like crap right now. To Chan, wow, what do I say? Thank you. This is where I started crying in my last video, in last year's video. I remember that so clearly. Thank you for everything you do, for Stays, for Stray Kids, for the industry, for our generation, because our generation needs people like you to lead, to just, yeah, to lead us, to set good examples for the next generations, and you set a very pretty damn good example for the next generation. I hope that you receive as much love as you give out, because like, you exude so much like love and like positivity and like grace and like elegance and like all those things, and strength and patience. I could go on and on, but I hope that you get that back in return. I feel like it's a kind of going off track. I feel like it's kind of a different thing to reap the benefits of like physical work, like awards and such. Those are physical benefits of hard work. But in the other sense of like emotional health and like mental health, it's harder to receive the love that you give out. So I hope that you are receiving lots of love and hugs and support when you need it, because you are, again, you are our haven. So I hope that you have your own haven when you need it as well. Thank you for being vulnerable this year. I feel like there's a lot of that happened this year. It's hard to be vulnerable. in this day and age. It really is, especially for guys. Frick, I don't know how you guys do it. Like girls can just say whatever like this, but I feel like for guys it's slightly different. So thank you for being vulnerable. Thank you for being here. Your presence in the world is enough. I don't know how to explain that. Your presence in the world is just very, that alone is very appreciated. Because just your presence, like I said, exudes grace and like royalty and like thank you for being unafraid, because as you're unafraid and as you are brave, you give bravery and strength to others, and that's pretty cool. I hope you take care of yourself, because you take care of others, so you need to take care of yourself too. Wow, that sounded like very personal, on a personal level. Jeez. You. Anyway. I mean, not you, but like, you in the sense that you, like, ew, like feelings. I hate them. Just take care of yourself, please. Stay healthy. Because it's gonna be cold. It's gonna be winter soon. Frick. Right? Frick, it's September. No, it's not September. It's October! Holy I said a bad word and I don't say bad words on this channel. Oh my god, it's October. Yeah, please stay healthy. Please stay hydrated and don't overwork yourself. And finish Food Wars if you haven't. I say that as if I am talking to a longtime friend. I kind of am. Wow, I just got really personal on that video. Wow, I might just get rid of some of that. The power of editing. In conclusion, happy 23rd birthday, Bang Chan. Here's to another year of great things from you and for you and around you. What do I say? Yeah. If this was a normal YouTube video, I would be like, subscribe, comment, but this is not a normal YouTube video, so comment down below. Say happy birthday to Chan, because it's his birthday. If you've been watching the past, however long this video is going to be once I edit it, then you'll, it's obviously his birthday. if you liked this video of me rambling on and on about a person I haven't met in my life, give it a like and comment and subscribe, because I don't know why you would like that, but okay, go off, I guess. Yeah, thank you for watching this weird, very interpersonal video.